Very good evening, respected sir and all my team members. Today we are going to deliver a PowerPoint presentation on deterministic and non-deterministic finite automata, and as part of the assignment of the subject compiler design. And today's date is 5th December 2020. The PowerPoint presentation will be delivered by a team of four people, namely Anirban, Othri, Anunna, and of course myself, Anik. First of all, I would hand over to Anunna to define what deterministic and non-deterministic automata is. Then I'll differentiate, and then I'll pass on to Anirban and Othri to go on with the examples and questions in the end. First of all, Anunna, over to you, Anunna.
Thank you, Anik. I am explaining deterministic finite automata. In a DFA, for a particular input character, the machine goes to one state only. A transition function is defined on every state for every input symbol. In DFA, null move is not allowed. It means DFA cannot change state without any input character. DFA can be represented by five tuples, that is Q, Sigma, Delta, Q0 and F. In this diagram, Q0 is Q0, Q1, Q2. Sigma is 0, 1. Q0 is starting state. F is final state. That means Q2. In this transition function, Q is expressed by Q cross sigma arrow Q. Here, capital Q is Q0, sigma is 0, and Q is Q1. For input 0, the machine goes to the state Q1, which is capital Q. Next slide, please. Non-deterministic finite automata. NFA is similar to DFA except following additional features. For 1, null move is allowed. 2, ability to transmit to any number of states for a particular input, that means it contains multiple next state. NDFA can be represented by 5 tuples. All are same as DFA. But here, delta, the transition function is different. Here, we express this expression by capital Q cross delta arrow 2 to the power Q. Here, 2 to the power Q is used for multiple state. Thank you. Now, I hand it over to Anik.
Thank you, Anunna, for handing over to me. And I will go on with the differences between DFA and NFA. The very first difference between DFA and NFA is in DFA, dead configuration is not allowed. And in case of NFA, dead configuration is allowed. Like, but if you look at the diagram, for DFA, both 0 and 1 have to be defined. For 0, Q0 goes to Q1. For 1, it goes to Q2. That is, all the symbols need to be defined. That is, dead configuration is basically not allowed. But in case of NFA, only 0 is defined and 1 is not defined. That is, dead configuration is allowed since only 0 is defined. Secondly, multiple choices are not available in case of DFA corresponding to an input. And in case of NFA, multiple choices are available corresponding to an input. If you look at the diagram again, for Q0, in case of DFA, both 0 and 1, there are two different inputs and there are two different outputs for each of the corresponding inputs. But in case of NFA, there is only one input and there are two different outputs for one input. Thirdly, DFA cannot use empty string transition. NFA can use empty string transition, which means that even if there is no symbol involved, even if there is no symbol to go to the next transition state, NFA can go to the next can make a transition to the next state. But in case of DFA, it is not possible. In case of DFA, we need a symbol to go on to the next state. That's all. I would now hand over to Othri to go on and elaborate on the examples. Over to you, Othri.
Thank you, Anik, for handing over to me. And I will explain the NFA transition, how to make a transition table of a NFA. So here we can see that there is a NFA defined with transition states of Q0, Q1 and Q2 with transition symbols of 0 and 1, initial state Q0 and the final state Q2. And we can see the diagram of the NFA. Now, what is transition table? Transition table is a table that defines all the state and how it goes from one state to another by a specified symbol. For example, here we can see that Q0 on getting an input of 0 goes to Q0 and also to Q1. And in the if it gets input of 1, it goes to Q1. Similarly, Q1 on getting an input of 0 goes to Q0, and on getting an input of 1, it goes to Q0. And now comes the final state Q2. Q2 loops over itself and always goes to on getting 0 and 1, it goes to itself. But on getting 1, it also goes to Q1. Next slide. Next slide only. Yes. Now we will see another example of a language and how it is defined. So here we can see that there is a natural language where there is a W, and W belongs to 0 and 1, and is W is a string that doesn't contain consecutive ones. So how you can define this diagram? So here we can see that we can define it by giving it four states, and firstly we will draw a diagram that would go for consecutive ones, and then after that we will translate it to the diagram that would make it for not consecutive ones. So here you can see the initial state is Q0, which loops over itself on getting an input of 0. On getting an input of 1, it goes to Q1, and Q1 similarly loops over itself when it gets input of 0, and goes to Q2 when it gets input of 1. Then Q2 on getting 0 comes to itself, and on getting Q1, it goes to Q3. Now Q3 is a dead state, so it is on getting 0 and 1, it always loops over itself, and Q0, Q1 and Q2 are the final states. Now I will hand over to Anirban for the last part of our presentation.
Thank you, Othri. Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to present the questions and answers of DFA and NFA. We have discussed about the theory of DFA and NFA, and here are some of the questions which is from the previous GATE questions. So the first question is, consider the language L given by the regular expression A plus B star B A plus B over the alphabet of set A and B. The smallest number of states needed in a deterministic finite state automata accepting L is, the options are given 3, 4, 5 and 6, the answer will be B. The reason of being the answer B is here given, like we have drawn the NFA of the given equation. Then we have drawn the transition table of the given NFA. After that, we have minimized the NFA and draw the DFA corresponding to the NFA. Next slide, please. So the next question is, under which of the following operation NFA is not closed? Here three operation is given, and the operation and the option D is none of the mentioned, and the answer will be none of the mentioned. As we know, NFA is said to be closed under the following operations like union, intersection, concatenation, clean, negation, because NFA of two different state will be NFA if the previous states which are taken as examples are NFA. Like for example, if A and B is following NFA, then the union of A and B will be also NFA. Next slide. Onik, next slide. Yeah.
Yes.
Thanks, Onik.
It's been, yeah.
The next question is, Let A be the NFA with N states. Which of the following is true? Here the four options are given, and the answer will be A. We will look into the explanation. Here the for explanation we have taken a diagram, NFA diagram. Let's explain the options that and find whether it's true or false. First, the option is the shortest word in LA has length at most n minus 1. But in the case of following diagram, we can see the shortest word which can be accepted is AA. And in the AA, there is only two symbol is given. So two symbol means n minus 1, where n is the number of states, n is 3, so option A is true. But if we look for the other options, like the shortest word in LA has length at least n, that is not true. Like AA equal to 2, which is n minus 1, but the option in the option it is saying it should be at least n. So option B is also true. And if we look for the C, here the shortest word not in LA has length at most n minus 1, but we can see the shortest word that is accepted by NFA is AAA, and that in the AAA there are three symbols that is equal to n, but which is violating the words saying in the option C, that is n minus 1. And the option D, there is the shortest word not in LA has length at least 10, which is also not true, because the shortest word not in LA will be epsilon, that is no symbol is given, so that's also false. So the option D is false. Let's go to the next slide. Okay, which of the following do you use to form an NFA from a regular expression? So there are four construction method is given: subset, parset, Thompson, and Scott. We know the subset, parset, and Scott is used to convert a DFA to NFA or the NFA to DFA. So the option C, the Thompson construction method, is the true answer. So here is the end of our PPT on NFA and DFA. Thank you everyone for your patience. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Very good.